Has anyone trimmed down like that before?
No.
See, I'm a little crazy. But see, now the sides are much clearer. Now that band is gonna grow out, and that's what's gonna help change the nail shape. First, we'll trim all the toenails,
yeah.
And then we're gonna put that band, the Onyfix,
okay,
after everything. Cause these nails have been bugging you a long time,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And how often would you go for a pedicure?
This is, she said, every 3 weeks.
You would go?
Yeah, 3 weeks for once a month. I go once a month.
Okay.
So
would it help?
The one, right?
Would it help when they did it?
Yeah, but when I'm there, I'm crying. I'm screaming.
Why are you crying? Are they just digging?
She's digging.
Okay. So
hopefully you're not gonna take it.
We're gonna take just enough to give you relief.
Okay.
But you see how the base here is much wider than here, how it's skinny?
Yeah.
When we put this band on and let it grow out, it's gonna force the nail to open up. So your pincer nail that is like this will start to open, and that way it'll be less painful for you.
Okay.
And that's the whole point. Instead of us doing surgery where we cut the sides and you're left with a skinny nail, we can do this without surgery.
Okay.
Now, if this doesn't work in the next couple of months and we don't see the nail opening, again, we can then consider possibly doing the surgery. Only if we need to, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not good for you to be dealing with the pain.
Yeah.
These nails are very curled. So I'm gonna start on this little one. So nothing should hurt. So if anything does, you let me know.
Okay.
And the reason, you know, this has happened, like I said, because all your toenails are curled. This is something that is just genetic. Something that you must have been born with. And you said, does someone else in your family have nails like this?
No, this is my parents, my dad, especially my dad.
The same kind of nails?
Yeah. That's why it's too small now, eh? Because they're 87 now, it's small.
Yeah, these are not easy nails to cut or take care of. So I'm gonna trim them. So in a way where you don't get any problems. And I know your doctor gave me nail fungal test,
mm-hmm,
for this, but like I told you, the free edge of the nail, you see how it's yellow here?
Mm-hmm.
That's the part of the nail that's not attached, but because this nail is so thick, it looks much more yellow, like it is fungus, but it's not.
Okay. Because fungus is contagious too, right?
Yes. And how did you find out about the nail salon next door?
I think I checked out when I'm watching your the YouTube. I said, oh, you're going to open soon. So I said, oh, why not? I should go there.
Oh, you're good.
Are there downstairs too, located?
It's right next to this office.
Oh,
it'll
okay.
Be right next door.
So next month, they're open next month?
Next week and a half, we're open.
Okay. So where can I book appointment? Just go online or?
Yeah, go online onto the website, but what you can always do in a week and a half, you can call the office here and they'll give you all the information to book.
Okay.
Because in a week and a half, then we'll have the phone set up next door, the phone number,
okay,
and then you can start booking.
So you own that too?
Yes, it was my idea.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Should.
Yeah. Do you ever cut your own toenails or too hard for you?
It's hard to bend.
No, it's not easy. Not easy, Tita. It's not easy.
I used to. So your dad is retired now?
He's retired now. I'm his retirement plan.
Uh-huh.
So.
So if you have a problem, just ask him, right? That's nice.
Yes. He is the man. I'm the boy. He's the master. I'm the student.
Uh-huh. And your sister, she's not
in. No, she's not in this. I'm the only crazy one to follow my dad.
Oh.
So this one, I'm just gonna make it a little shorter, okay? Little by little. Did the other ones hurt when I cut them?
No.
Very good. But I have not seen a pincer nail like this in a long time.
So in other words, I can't wear heels anymore?
You can, but the problem when you do wear heels, it puts too much pressure on the nail. Wow, so I can see whoever cut this one last, you see that spike?
Mm-hmm.
There's a big core, you see that?
Mm-hmm.
That's what pokes into the skin. We're gonna trim it in a way down the side to really give you relief for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
while the Onyfix helps change the nail shape. A little sensitive there?
A little bit,
yeah. Okay, sorry, Tita. We're gonna go nice and slow. Sorry. Is it the vibration that hurt, or you felt something sharp?
I feel
something. Okay. So there's a lot of thick nail.
Why my nail is too thick too? That's another.
Well, one, sometimes it's just genetics, and your nails do seem to be a little bit thicker everywhere. And the second thing is big toes always get banged up in the shoe.
Yeah.
And over time, they get bigger and bigger from all the pressure. And because your nails are so raised and curved, they probably hit the shoe more often than normal. So that's why they've reacted more.
So I have to wear a shoe, something extra on front? No.
No, but you should always, you know, by having the nail shorter, it won't hit the shoe as much. But the top of the shoe should be soft material. I can tell you have very sensitive feet. It must not be fun when you go to pedicure.
Yeah, usually it takes only half an hour or less, right? I usually stay there for an hour.
So it might be, I'm trying to make it as pain-free as possible, but if you do feel a little discomfort, you let me know. The more it can get off, the longer this will last. Oh yeah, that corner was in the skin. So I'm gonna trim the nail a little shorter. This is all lifted nail with a lot of dead skin underneath. No one cuts it too short, do they?
Mm-hmm, no.
Because I think they're scared.
And look ugly too.
Yes, but at the same time, it's better to trim it to where the nail is healthier.
Yeah.
And attached.
How often the nail grows? Every.
Oof. A full nail takes roughly 6 to 12 months to grow.
Oh, okay. But the nail, regular nails, grow every 3 weeks or?
To get cut, maybe a month and a half. Month.
A month. Oh.
You okay here?
Mm-hmm.
So your son's 30, huh? Almost my age.
Who?
He's almost my age.
Yeah, he's 30 and...
Sorry, Tita. Okay, got that piece out. Very good. You got big, clear spaces on either side now.
Supposed to be getting married in October, but because of the COVID, have to...
was
for next year.
Oh.
I know. But they moved together already. They bought a house in Brampton, and then said, "What's the use to get married if you're living together or not?"
That's right. Maybe they change their mind. Make it simple.
Just go to City Hall. They said, "No, we want big weddings. Whatever."
No, they want to spend the money.
For my son, it's okay. Just go to City Hall. That's it, right? But the fiance, she wants a big wedding.
She Filipina?
Yeah.
Oh. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's not been too bad?
So far.
I can tell you're very anxious. You've been through a lot with these poor toes. These are definitely not easy ones to cut. What did your doctor say when she saw these toenails?
She always says, "Oh, go to Thomas." Okay.
She says, "You've been telling you see me for a long time."
Yeah, I've been on and off. I said, "Oh, it's too far. I'm too busy and stuff like that."
So you finally made it.
Yeah, finally. One time I went to going here an appointment. I went to East.
That oh no.
East. That's why I called Laura. I said, "Oh, sorry, I have to cancel it."
You're doing amazing. I'm very impressed. Very good. I know it's a little sensitive. But we are going to really trim this back for you. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Get as much of this dead skin off. No pain, right? Right, doing this?
Mm-hmm. You got the corner ready?
Yeah.
That's quick.
I know, I'm gonna do a little bit more. See if I can get even more out. Of course, Tita, I'm Filipino, we're quick, we're good.
Tell me about it.
You know us Filipino, we try to do a good job.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, last little bit, I know a little sensitive. Okay. There we go, that's a big piece. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now you can breathe easy. So I cleared out this whole side.
Nothing was certain?
Take a look.
Oh, that's amazing.
You see all here?
Uh-huh.
All gone. This side too. So this will give you a lot more relief. No nail in the skin. And we're gonna put on this Onyfix system to try to physically change the shape of the nail without surgery. It's been doing very well. Has anyone cut this much before?
Not that low.
Okay. And the reason, I want to cut it back to where it's attached. We can go a little bit more, but for now, since it's your first appointment, we're going to go to this point, okay? Take a look in there. Look at the side. So all in here is completely open.
Good.
Okay, that one's done. We'll go to the next one. Looks better?
Yeah.
A little bit?
Lot, much better.
It does look better, right, the other one? Okay. I'm gonna buff down the front of the nail afterwards as well, okay? So we're gonna do this foot now. It wasn't too painful?
Uh-huh.
A little bit, right?
Just, yeah, it's like a pinch.
Just at the very end, that last one.
Mm-hmm.
But I think your feet are very sensitive. I think it's because you've been tortured too many times. But it's unbelievable how curled these toenails are. But the little ones really don't bother you, huh?
No.
Which is good, I'm happy to hear.
Those corns, we cannot do anything about it.
The corn here?
Uh-huh.
The only way we get corns like that is from pressure from the shoes. So that you're wearing shoes that are too narrow and snug on the foot. So you got the Filipino wide foot, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so problem, women's shoes are very narrow.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's squishing your foot. So I'm gonna file those down and it'll feel better, but the problem is we're treating the symptom, not the cause. The cause is the shoe. So you need to be wearing shoes that are much wider.
Do you have any shoes here, or they can?
No, I don't sell shoes here.
Oh.
So what kind of shoes? What kind of shoes do you normally wear for work?
I wear heels, so because I got one in the morning heels, and the afternoon I got flat shoes.
So the problem with heels, obviously, heels are very narrow.
Uh-huh.
Flat shoes too can be not wide enough. So you need to be using or choosing shoes that maybe don't have a strap here, or more rounded.
Okay. Like running shoes thing?
Oh, running shoes would be the best, but if you're able to wear running shoes, are you?
Yeah.
Then I definitely would stop wearing flats and heels and try the best to wear a running shoe.
And the big white.
Yes.
VW.
And what size shoes do you wear?
9.
I would even suggest you wear a men's running shoe.
Men's running shoe?
Yes, because the men's will have a wider width for you, and that's what you need. You need a wider width shoe. Oh yes, Tita. If you can wear a running shoe, do it. It'll save your feet. So again, this last little corner out, you okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that little piece that's stuck to the skin here, there we go. Those were the easy ones. Now this one, same thing, just like we did on the other foot, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I can't believe you watched some of those videos. You're brave. Were they scary to watch?
Yes, some of them. It's amazing, my God, the difference.
In some of those people, right?
And people doesn't know that.
Mm-hmm. I'm happy your doctor told you to go look at the videos. Now you're gonna have your own video. Well, let me do something cool. Let me try to make this one more vertical, so that everyone can see the angle that I cut it on. Very steep. Trying to get the corner out. And a little pinch might come at the end, but you've done very good. Very good, very good. This nail has a lot of dead skin.
I put Vaseline at night, it put socks. Doesn't help?
It helps to keep it soft, but I think a lot of this dead skin is a buildup from that as well. So very big piece.
That's it?
Yep, but we're gonna do a little bit more. A little bit more of a steeper angle. Show it to Dad so he can see how I'm doing. He can tell me if I'm doing good or bad. So we got a little bit more space on the card. So again, I'm gonna trim this a little shorter. So this is all dead, lifted nail. And that's why underneath, sorry. You're getting a lot of dead skin buildup. This is not real skin. It's all dead. But there is real nail bed deeper down there.
What's the cause of the nail die?
It's not dead, it's lifted. Oh. It's lifted. So dead skin that's underneath the nail bed is building up. See all this?
Mm-hmm.
Some of this might be dead skin, some Vaseline left over, all this stuff.
Oh.
Sorry. So now we can start to see more of the healthier nail or the nail bed underneath. Okay. Do a little bit more. So the reason I'm cutting it, I guess, short for you that you've never seen anyone do, is we want to get it to where it's attached. That way the front edge doesn't look so yellow and lifted. It'll look more pink. You okay still?
Mm-hmm. It's so ugly inside.
No, it's just a lot of dead skin, unfortunately. Yes, it can help the nail reconnect much better. So I'm just checking the corner, making sure I didn't leave any sharp spike. So much more room. Getting all this little bit of dead skin out, you okay? So now these sides are much clearer with nothing poking into the front. Does it feel any different?
A little bit there.
A little sensitive? Okay, there's one little edge that I can clean out a little bit more. I'm going nice and slow. Again, if you feel that little pinch.
Yes.
Okay, almost done, Tita. I'm sorry. This is the part that's just in this into the skin. Okay. You okay there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I know it's not easy. There's a lot of dead skin. That's what you're actually feeling here. This is dead skin that I'm pulling out. You see all that come out? Okay. Awesome. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to prepare the nails for the Onyfix. Then after I have the little band on, then I'm going to file everything else down, okay? Okay, so first I'm going to buff the nail down. This does not hurt. Just going to get rid of as much of the rough or the smooth surface of the nail. We want to have a very smooth, dry nail edge. Again, shouldn't feel anything, just a little bit of vibration. Rubbing up or to really dry out that nail. So this is just a primer. It's going to help the material stick onto the nail. Now we're going to activate that.
Is that laser?
Nope, so this is just a blue light. It's not it's not UV. It's just an LED blue light, that's it. And this is what's going to activate the band or the compound that we're going to stick on the nail to hold the nail in a better shape as it grows out. Yeah, a lot of people think it's something bigger, but it's not. It's just a little bit of material that we're going to shape to fit the back of the nail. And like I said, the whole goal is to promote a healthier, flatter nail growth. You're doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
And this doesn't hurt, does it?
No. Isn't that
going to
come out?
Nope. So the amazing thing is when we put that blue light on here, it makes it hard.
Oh.
Just like, think of like a cavity.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Filling.
Fillings, yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay, very good. And that's it.
Oh, I thought you put on the side, so that it will not grow in the side, no?
No, so what we're doing is we place the band on, we make this hard with this blue light.
Uh-huh.
So as your nail grows and the nail wants to curl in, it's holding it open.
Oh, okay.
And so you know how the nail was very wide at the back and very skinny at the front, it goes inwards like a triangle?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna force the nail to stay open.
On this side, okay.
Yes. And the amazing thing about this, there's no tension, there's no extra pressure needed. We actually just promote the nail to grow in a more natural way. The nail grows from the base of the nail. So we're not trying to twist the nail and open it with force. That's why it's not painful.
Wow.
So this is gonna stay on your toe for the next 3 to 4 months. It's gonna grow out near the end.
October, back in October.
And so around October, we come back in to see how far the band has grown out. And if it's reached near the end of your toenail or just past half, we're gonna put on a second application.
So it's working then?
Yes, if we see that it's opening up and widening.
Mm-hmm.
But for sure we do these two applications.
Okay.
and see how well the nail grows. So in 6 months total, we will have two bands on there and we'll see how well they...
Oh, you're gonna put them top?
Yes, oh. We start again at the beginning.
Oh, okay.
And what happens, every time we put on the band, we see that the nail gets wider and wider and wider and wider, and that's what we want. Mm-hmm. We're slowly opening up the nail. So, we're gonna feel a little bit of cool water, and we're just going to take down and smooth out the nails, okay? Okay. Okay.
And that one becomes locked to it.
It's not dead, it's just with different ethnicities, Filipinos, Africans, Latino, we get a black nail sometimes as the nail gets thicker. And it's not cancer, it's not fungus, it's just the way the nail responds with getting thick. So just removing a little bit of that dead skin here. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
So like I said, now you can shower, you can get the foot wet, it's okay. Look at that now.
Wow,
how does that look? So same thing on this one, how's that look? Much better, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this toe might be a little bit sensitive for a little bit, since I know it's sore when cutting. But there's no nail in the skin anymore. We really cleaned out the sides really well. Now, what we could do is you can come back in maybe 6 weeks
mm-hmm.
to trim the nails.
Okay.
You see how the nails are doing. But we really don't have to do anything for the big toenails for the next possibly 4 months. We're just watching it as it grows out.
So when I go pedicure, they're not going to touch it? They cannot touch?
No, they don't have to touch it. No.
Oh, okay.
What they'll do is they'll basically just trim the normal nails like you can,
yeah.
like we normally do. But they'll just clean out the corners. They don't actually have to take anything off. So normal nail polish can be used on top of this, but we can see how deep I cleaned out those sides.
Mm-hmm.
Does that look better to you?
Much better.